Financial matters can cause overwhelming stress in our lives, and the lack of resources and options can truly increase the burden. My special guest is the founder of Zeallionaire Enterprises, and today she and I discuss transforming your relationship with money.
I'm Melanie Perry, founder of Zeallionaire Enterprises and the author of All About the Benjamins and Jonathan and Geneva, The Adventures of Zeallionaire Kids, and you're watching The Chandra Show.
Many people share a lack of confidence when it comes to financial matters. So how do you encourage your clients to transform their relationship with money? Yeah. It can be a daunting experience to think about it, worry about it, not feel like you don't have enough.
Yeah.
How do you break that?
I gotta tell you, 80% of what I do is emotional finance.
Oh.
That's the term.
Oh, okay.
In helping people understand how to just kind of let those fears and anxieties about your money and finances kind of dissipate is to really recognize your purpose. When you know your purpose, then that's gonna drive you to focus on what you need to do in order to make that happen. Mm-hmm. The very first thing I talk to people about is, why are you here? What do you want to do? And it could be, I want to be the best mom I want to be, or it could be, I want to build a $1 trillion enterprise.
Right.
I mean, whatever it is, be it quote big or small, when you have clarity of your purpose, then that frames your mindset of how you can go about achieving what you think.
It's all in our minds.
It's everything, right? Everything starts with the mind.
It's all in our minds, and it affects our bank accounts. Mm-hmm. It's an ideal money mindset to have when you constantly have that sinking feeling that you don't have enough. I know we talked about purpose, so we're gonna lay that down again. Is it truly possible for anyone to save?
Oh, definitely, yes.
Okay.
Yeah, and so when I come across a person that's like, well, I'm starting my business, or I just graduated from college, mm-hmm. and I don't have the money, or I've got 20 kids and I'm spending money out.
Right.
You can save a dollar.
You can save a dollar.
If you get in the habit, and see, there is a 52-week challenge that sometimes I mm-hmm. suggest.
It comes around every December.
Yeah. And right. so it starts off literally saving a dollar a week.
Right.
And then you double that every single week to the point where I believe at the end.
It's like $1,200 or something like
something
that, right?
Something like that, okay. right? Somewhere between $1,200 and $2,000 you end up saving. And so if you just, the fact of the matter is that if you just get in the habit of being consistent. Being consistent mm-hmm. with whatever it is. So people who are entrepreneurs have variable income, right? So I can't save a dollar.
Right.
Don't save a dollar. Save a percentage.
Right.
Tell yourself you're going to start saving 1%, 2%, 5%, 20%, whatever it is. Be consistent with that. And every time something comes in, you close the deal, save 1% of that and be consistent. And it can start in an envelope. It doesn't have to start in the bank. Mm-hmm. It can start in an envelope, and you don't touch that envelope because that envelope has a clear purpose. And so you just start with that 1%, you start with that $1, and then next thing you know, you open up that envelope and you've got multiple dollars in there.
Multiple dollars.
You've got multiple
that you didn't even
assets.
Miss, I'm pretty sure.
Right.
You didn't even miss it.
And that's the other, I'm glad you brought that up, because that's the other critical piece, is a lot of things just out of sight, out of mind. And when you develop that discipline, you develop that focus and that purpose, then you realize, oh my gosh, I can do this. This is not as hard
as
I was making it out to be.
And then the next year you could double it up or triple it up, and then now once you see the return on it. I like that goal. I like that goal a lot.